Hello, beautiful beings. I am Daniel Alcyon, and I'm coming to you from the beautiful Dayalu Center on Bainbridge Island, Washington. This is the studio that I teach a lot of classes and workshops and series at, so check it out. It's an amazing facility, absolutely gorgeous, okay? We're gonna be checking out some basic fundamental poses today. I heard a lot of feedback from you all out there that you wanna see some of like the yoga basics, you know? How do we break down these yoga basics? And I'm gonna show you two of the most fundamental poses, Warrior One and Warrior Two. In Sanskrit, this is Virabhadrasana One and Virabhadrasana Two. So there's some real differences here. And sometimes when you're starting out, it's hard to even understand what they are. So we're gonna talk about them. Now, first of all, these poses are both warrior poses, right? This is the pose of the warrior. So you need to shift your thinking a little bit and think of the spiritual warrior. You need to think of walking the path, the center path, the middle path between aggression and passivity, right? So this is the warrior of spirit going out into the world and standing up for justice and truth and peace and love and harmony and all the things that you are consciously cultivating in your life. That's the kind of warrior we're talking about here. So let's break it down. Let's talk about what we're doing here, okay? First, we're going to go into Warrior One. So for Warrior One pose, the hips are going to be forward. The front knee is bent. I'll show you this from a couple angles here. So from the side, the front knee is bent. The back leg is on the earth. And it's to the point where the entire back foot touches the ground. So that heel is pivoted in very slightly. Okay? The hips are forward and hands lift up to the sky. This is your Warrior One pose here. The hands, the energy is a lifting of a spiritual sword, a lightning bolt sword. So from the front here, my hips are forward, my hands are lifted, my heart is lifted, my gaze is lifted up to the heavens. And there's some great key factors here that we get into. So you're in a position, you're in a stance that both feet are firmly rooted into the ground. You feel the entire front foot, all four corners of the front foot, you feel the entire back foot as well. So I'm not popped up onto the ball of the foot, okay? I'm not up on the ball of the foot. This is crescent pose or high lunge, but I'm gonna pivot that heel down so the back foot is fully on the ground. It's an inward rotation of that back leg. That gives the stability of a warrior, right? We're talking about warrior pose here, so we want to be really firm. You want your warrior pose to be so strong that you can get hit from a strong wind from the side and you're not gonna fall over, okay? So in Warrior One also, we're settled in here, your hips facing forward, right? So that means if you had headlights on your hips, your headlights would be pointing straight down the lane, right? Not veered off to the side. If your headlights are pointed off to the side of your lane, you're gonna wanna rein that back in and adjust the positioning of the back leg so that your headlights are straight. So you can even put your hands on your hips like this and check in that your headlights are aligned up straight, okay? So headlights straight, hands on the hips, you check that out. And then from there, the hands sweep up and out to the sky. The hands are open, lifting that mighty sword, right? And then there's an articulation, there's a specific positioning of the shoulders, okay? So in Warrior One here, facing the side, as you lift these arms up, the shoulders don't come up by the ears. If the shoulders are up by the ears, you're causing an instability in your shoulder area. It's not strong, and you're doing a warrior pose, you want it to be strong. So you can have the energy of lifting up with the hands, lift up as high as you can, arms straight, and then root the shoulders back down. So again, the hands lift up, 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 root those shoulders back down. Boom, into the back. That's strong. So The energy is like plugging it into a socket, okay? You have the head of the shoulder joint and you're plugging it in to the back of the shoulders. So there's a lift through the hands, there's a lift through the heart, the throat, the third eye, and the crown, and there's a lifting up, dropping down of the shoulders. Notice that difference? Here, shoulders by ears. It's like trapped. I'm trapped in the neck. This doesn't feel good. Back down, widening out, opening up through here and lifting. There's the energy. This lift up, pull it back down, okay? That's your warrior one. Virabhadrasana one, all right? And you're gonna wanna cultivate this energy of stepping into this from standing. A standing posture is called Tadasana. That's just standing in awareness. And let's talk about that a little bit before we go on to warrior two, because it's very important to come from a still, centered, solid point before you move anything. So if you're standing like this, if you're just standing kind of sloppy, right? And you're trying to find warrior one, it's gonna be really hard to find where it is, okay? However, if you're standing in Tadasana, and then you find warrior one, it's right there. It's so much easier, okay? So Tadasana is mountain pose. This is our standing at attention pose. And what we're gonna do for Tadasana is the feet are going to be directly under the hips. And then we're going to, for me, I have to pigeon toe the tiniest bit. I bring my toes rotated in so that my big toes are parallel. So find your big toe parallel. The heels may be slightly wide. And what this allows is a subtle rolling and opening of the hips. The hips come forward and open up a little bit. The glutes have maybe 5 or 10% engagement. The legs are drawing energy up the legs like the roots of a tree, rooting down into the earth, pulling energy up the core, up the legs, okay? The hands in Tadasana are heavy, like sandbags. They're heavy and soft. The shoulders follow the hips, so the hips have this little opening. The shoulders as well have a little opening. They roll back. The shoulder blades come towards each other. Hands very soft and heavy. The chin is lifted just above the horizon. And the gaze is strong yet soft. That's Tadasana. So from your Tadasana, develop a point that you can step into warrior one. You would bring one leg back, the heel turns slightly in, the hands lift up to the sky. The pelvis pushes forward, lifting the heart up to the sky, right? Shoulders rooted down on the back. And you step back in, Tadasana, right? Do the other side, step the foot back, plant that heel, hands lift to the sky, pelvis moving forward, heart lifting to the sky. Virabhadrasana one. Come back down, you can come through heart center. Always cultivating this graceful, fluid movement. Okay? You want every single motion, every single step that you take in your yoga practice to be yoga. So yoga isn't just here's Tadasana, here's warrior one. How do you link them together? The whole process becomes your yoga practice, okay? So we talked about warrior one, we talked about our standing position, which is Tadasana or mountain pose, right? And now here, let's think something about mountain pose. A lot of our yoga names, the names of the postures, tell us a thing or two about the energetics of the pose. So in mountain pose, you look at a big, beautiful mountain, right? That mountain is powerful. It's strong, secure, it's confident in itself because that mountain is so timeless that it doesn't have to worry about being anything else. But here's the trick, that mountain is effortless, okay? A mountain is completely effortless. It doesn't have to try to be a mountain. It doesn't have to try to be strong, right? So when you do your mountain pose, your Tadasana, you find that effortless strength. That place that all the muscles hug the bones and bring in ease. So it's not a flexing, but it's like this confident, strong presence. Okay? Now let's talk about warrior two. We're gonna change it around. We're gonna do warrior two. Another fundamental pose, Virabhadrasana two. Now, warrior two is an open hip pose. What in the world does that mean? Remember the headlights? We talked about the headlights being forward in Warrior 1. Warrior 1, here's my headlights. They're going forward down the lane. My hands are lifted. In Warrior 2, that hip's going to open up to the side. So even though I'm still facing forward, my hips have turned. My headlights are now pointing to the side of the room. Okay? So let's look at it this way. I'm going to find Tadasana, that comfortable, strong mountain pose standing position. And often in Warrior 2, it's nice to windmill the back arm. So this back arm, I'm going to windmill it up and over. I'm going to step the back foot back. Okay? In Warrior 1, the toes were pointing forward. Here in Warrior 2, the back leg has pivoted 90 degrees. It's opened up to the side. So my hips now also open up to the side. Okay? Several alignments here that we have. In Warrior 2, your arms reach out. You're looking ahead over the front hand. The shoulders are dropped down away from the ears. They're not hunched up. You're dropped down. And you create this straight line, this horizontal line in the arms. So, not here, not here. I'm not hinging at the waist forward like this. I'm not leaning back. I'm straight up and down in the spine. Even though the legs are out like this, the spine is vertical. It's stacked up. The arms reach out from center in a nice straight line, okay? The front leg, the knee, is directly over the foot. You don't want to lean so far forward that that knee goes further than the toe. That's going to cause some instability in the legs. So you bring that back. You want to just be able to peek the big toenail past the knee, right? The back leg turned to the side, finding equal weight in the foot. So I'm not rolled onto the big toe edge of the foot. I'm not leaning back onto the pinky toe edge of the foot. I'm equalizing the weight, okay? Feeling all four corners of both feet. The back leg is straight without hyperextending. If you have a micro bend, that's okay. And then the alignment here, it's like we're walking a tightrope, right? So the front heel, that left heel, goes straight back in alignment with the back arch of the back foot. And that's what happens when we open up, right? You get to this beautiful position, reaching out, and again, there's a reaching out of the shoulders and hugging them back in. They pull into the sockets a little bit, strong shoulders here, soft hands, strong gaze, right? And so you're gonna cultivate the practice to step in and out of it. As you step forward, the arms come forward, you step up. Tadasana, mountain pose. You'll find your other side. Windmill, step it back with control. Warrior 2, stepping forward, release. You want everything in your practice to be smooth and fluid, right? Controlled motions, controlled steps. Warrior 1, forward headlights. Tadasana, we talked about that pose, the standing pose. And Warrior 2, where we open up the hips, right? So now, if you're a little more advanced, you already have a yoga practice going, we can always come back to these refinements. We can always come back to these little details that makes the practice juicy. If you've done Warrior 2 20,000 times in your life, you can find it brand new because this time you're doing it is the first time. You know, you can enter each pose like it's the very first time you've done it, right? Now imagine, if you were to kiss your lover like every time was the very first time, it would be magic. It would be passion, right? And that's what we do with our practice. Don't enter it into it like, oh, Warrior 2 again. You're robbing yourself. You're stealing your own experience away. So enter into that experience like it's brand new, right? And then if you do have a little more experience, practice with your speed. Try to go slow motion. Anything you do slowly is exceptionally more challenging. It takes more control. It takes more balance, right? It takes more center. So, a couple times, so I'm showing you slowly. If you're going to come slowly, you find the top of your mat, and then all the control. Coming back, Warrior 2. Stepping forward, slow motion. Right? So there's infinite levels you can go to, even in these basic fundamental poses. Warrior 1, Warrior 2, how fluidly can you move in and out? How can you make this a beautiful dance of the warrior in these energies? Okay?
So there's your practice for today. Let's play with Warrior 1, Warrior 2, and then as you're in these poses, if you hold it for a while, cultivate what energy you are a warrior of. What are you a warrior of in this world? What are you standing up for? What are you, you know, holding ground for in the world as a warrior? Okay? And I'm going to leave you off with a little fun thing here. What I have is this deck of cards. And these are pretty fun. I'll often have students draw these at the end of a class. Okay? So these are called crazy, sexy love notes that we're going to draw today. And we're going to find what one is right. Let's see. Ooh. This one. And every single time, the right card shows up, okay? So this is the message that needs to be heard today, out from you and from me. So this is what we all need to hear. It says, it's time to rise. It's time to rise. This beautiful image of a woman being lifted by a heart-shaped balloon. And on the back it says, no matter what's happening in our lives, we always have the potential to rise above it. Rising is one powerful choice away. Rise out of our negative thoughts or our limiting beliefs. Rise out of our comfort zone or our complaints. Rise out of our slump or out of the potato chip bag. Get up and rise. What are you waiting for, darling? Get up and rise. That's the message for today. I love you all so much. Reach out, let me know, drop some comments, share this video with others, and let me know if you want to see more of these fundamental yoga videos. I love you so much. Take care.